Good evening. We had this morning that first reading about the serpent being put on a stick and held up for people to look at if they had been bitten by serpents in order that they might be saved. It remains, I should have mentioned this morning in my homily, remains the symbol of the World Health Organization, an appropriate reading that we might reflect on this day as we mark the year's anniversary of lockdown, and as particularly we come together to pray for all those who've gone before us, marked with the sign of faith during this time of pandemic. The gospel invited us to raise our eyes to the Lord. If you were here in the church and raised your eyes, you would discover the crucifix veiled, that sense that we wait with anticipation for the resurrection and new life. As we begin this evening prayer, we do focus on all those who have suffered and are suffering because of the pandemic. We give thanks too to God for all those whose work, whose ministry, whose extraordinary care has enabled to guide many of us through this time. So it's that mixture of thanksgiving which leads to confidence in God, which leads us to be able to bring our intercession and our prayer. It's the process through which Our Lady lived her whole life. We begin by recalling the beginning of her journey in the Angelus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, come to our aid. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Now let us all in one accord, in fellowship with ages past, keep vigil with our heavenly Lord in his temptation and his fast. The covenant so long revealed to faithful men in former time, Christ by his own example sealed, the Lord of love in love sublime. Remember, Lord, though frail we be, by your own kind hand were we made, and help us all, lest our frailty cause your great name to be betrayed. Hear us, O Trinity sublime and undivided unity, so let this consecrated time bring forth its fruit abundantly. The Lord will give victory to his anointed one. May the Lord answer in time of trial, May the name of Jacob's God protect you. May he send you help from his shrine and give you support from Zion. May he remember all your offerings and receive your sacrifice with favor. May he give you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your plans. May we ring out our joy at your victory and rejoice in the name of our God. May the Lord grant all your prayers. I am sure now that the Lord will give victory to his anointed, will reply from his holy heaven with the mighty victory of his hand. Some trust in chariots or horses, but we in the name of the Lord. They will collapse and fall, but we shall hold and stand firm. Give victory to the King, O Lord. Give answer on the day we call. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord will give victory to his anointed one. We shall sing and praise your power. O Lord, your strength gives joy to the king. How your saving help makes him glad. You have granted him his heart's desire. You have not refused the prayer of his lips. You came to meet him with the blessings of success. You have set on his head a crown of pure gold. He asked you for life, and this you have given, days that will last from age to age. Your saving help has given him glory. You have laid upon him majesty and splendor. You have granted your blessings to him forever. You have made him rejoice with the joy of your presence. The king has put his trust in the Lord. Through the mercy of the Most High, he shall stand firm. O Lord, arise in your strength. We shall sing and praise your power. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. We shall sing and praise your power. Lord, you have made us a kingdom and priests to serve our God. Worthy are you, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they existed and were created. Worthy are you, O Lord, to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed men for God from every tribe and tongue and people and nation. You have made us a kingdom and priest to our God, and we shall reign on earth. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honor and glory and blessing. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Lord, you made us a kingdom and priests to serve our God. To shame what is strong, God chose what is weak by human reckoning. Those whom the world thinks common and contemptible are the ones that God has chosen. Those who are nothing at all, to show up those who are everything. The human race has nothing to boast about to God, but you, God, has made members of Christ Jesus, and by God's doing, he has become our wisdom and our virtue and our holiness and our freedom. I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. He who sent me is with me, and he has not left me to myself, for I always do what pleases him. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me. holy his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones and raises the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his sons forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. He who sent me is with me, and he has not left me to myself, for I always do what pleases him. Let us pray earnestly to Christ the Lord. He tells us to watch and pray that we may not fall into temptation. Hear us, Lord, and have mercy. Lord Jesus, you promised to be with those who are gathered in your name. Keep us united with you as we pray to the Father in the Holy Spirit. Cleanse your church from every stain of sin. Make her alive with hope and the power of the Spirit. Help us to care for our neighbor and show your love for all. Through us, let the light of your salvation shine in the world. Let your peace spread to the ends of the earth. Let all see in every place the signs of your presence. Bring the dead to everlasting happiness. Let glory and immortal life be theirs. I hope you'll understand, feel it's the right thing to do. We take those regular prayers which we include and make sure that they're here on the votive candle stand as part of our prayer. But this day, focus on the particular requests, intercessions that have been sent in, looking back over this last year and recalling by name all those who we wish to pray for. Emma asks that we might pray for the repose of the soul of her cousin, Jerry, who died of COVID on Sunday. Raymond asks that we might pray for Janet, who died of the virus in April last year. Carol asks that we might pray for Geraldine, for Peter Hart, for Sandy, and for Lee Jones. We join with the Melly family in praying for Gordon Cameron. We pray for Eddie MacDonald, Terence Nagel, Pat Blake, and Patricia Larkin. Marlene has sent in a reminder of all the countries affected. We join with her in praying for all those communities around the world. We pray also for Fernando, for Juan, for Pablo, for Fernanda, for Jupiter, we pray for the Rohingya people suffering from the terrible fire that ripped through the camp in Bangladesh yesterday. And two other prayers which came in today. Rosemary asks that we might pray for her daughter-in-law, Laurel, and for her husband, Alex, for the safe delivery of their premature child. Finally, this day is also the first anniversary of Deacon Thomas, as he was then, arrived in the parish. A number of people have asked that we might give thanks for the great blessing which he is to this community. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. May your people, Lord, persevere in obedience to your will, so that through this obedience your church in our time may grow in grace and increase in numbers. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. As part of our weekly pattern, we have this evening at 7 o'clock adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. As the bishops had suggested that churches should be open for adoration this day, we will have the doors of the church opened here if anyone wanted to come and join us. We'll make sure that the benches are cleaned afterwards, so it'll be a very sort of discreet and calm thing. No need to book, no need for stewards, etc. And we'll be here. Sorry, I smile, because one of the things that became clear at the team meeting this afternoon, as we were agreeing that all three of us would be here to pray together from 7, is that I said, oh, we'll be there for half an hour, because that's what I've been doing on Tuesdays, is half an hour. Father Thomas said, oh, I've been thinking it was an hour. Father Roy thought it was somewhere between the two. So we'll pray probably for about 45 minutes together. The important thing is that we do have that opportunity to pray in front of the Blessed Sacrament together, to bring all the intentions of this year past and of the year to come and entrust them to the Lord. We know that we can entrust these things to the Lord because of all that he has already done for us and given us. We come to a decade of the Rosary. I was going to suggest Tuesday, of course, is Sorrowful Mysteries. I think this should really be week 5, but that seems appropriate to have next week in Holy Week. So I suggest that we continue the reflection we began last week about that extraordinary burden that he bears for us, about the carrying of the cross. And bearing the cross for himself, he went forth to the place called the Skull, in Hebrew, Golgotha. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those most in need of your mercy.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, Espes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Evae. A te suspiramus, gementes efflentes, in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego, advocata nostra, illos tuos, misericordes loquos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fruntum ventris tui, nobis, post hoc exilium, ostende. O clemens, O pia, O Duchess, Virgo Maria.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.